Our brains store a huge amount of information in memory, so we can't possibly know when some auditory or visual stimulation will trigger neuronal nostalgia. At the point of a triggering moment, we aren't aware of what memory our body is remembering, but we can often feel sadness rise within us. Such a moment may make you overthink, become sad and lazy, or even break down and cry. Not knowing where the sadness is coming from can be extremely exhausting. There are many things that can trigger such a reaction. For example, trust takes years to build, but only seconds to break. When your trust is broken by someone very close to you, or someone you're in a relationship with, it becomes difficult for you to trust anyone else after that. We can then experience regret for trusting the person and wish that we could have known their intentions from the very beginning. This can lead to feelings of loneliness, alienation, and isolation. Whether you're with people or not, you still feel alone, self-absorbed, and insulated from commitments. If you're a sensitive person, you may always worry and overthink what others tell you, think about you, or say about you. If you're an empathetic person, you're more likely to feel sad, since you so often put yourself in other people's shoes. When you are so invested in helping others, you often mask your feelings and stop considering your own mental health. Other reasons that cause unexplained sadness may include traumatic experiences, tragic past events, such as abusive relations, or the loss of someone close to you, can make you feel depressed even many years later. Grief that you carry can be triggered at any time, as can feelings of guilt that you carry about something else. Sadness also depends on perception. Perception refers to how much you let a situation affect you, whether the case dominates your emotions, or if you control the situations and feelings. On another level, social factors like your parents, peers, and even broader society can put restrictions on you, which can make you feel sad and controlled by outside forces. Authority and forceful restrictions significantly affect mental health. Sadness can also be caused by various hormonal changes, especially in females, when they go through their menstrual cycle or menopause. This causes changes in their mood, often making them feel sad. Men often feel sadness, but also widely feel the need to embody manhood, so they mask their emotions and keep everything to themselves, which opens them up to be triggered later. Age is another factor behind sadness. For example, in adolescence and old age, depression is more visible and unpredictable. The side effects of certain medicines or drugs, alcohol consumption, or tranquilizers can also subtly influence sadness. The way to cope with such phantom sadness is to talk to a professional or seek catharsis, a discharge of emotional tension. Try your best to be a positive and surround yourself with people who are good for your mental health. Life is a test and a challenge, and you will inevitably face loss and rejection. No one is promised a smooth ride through existence, but we must keep moving forward.